Hello, and welcome to day one of Vacation Bible School. I am so excited to be here with you, my friends, and let you know that I am doing well and I am finished with my big chemo, and I am so excited that I can be here to teach you about Jesus today. This year's Vacation Bible School theme is concrete and cranes. Doesn't that sound like fun? You can see that's why I'm in my construction gear. Do you think I'm here to teach you, though, about building a house or a building? No, I'm going to teach you about building on Jesus' great love. Today, we are building on the foundation of love, and we're going to talk about Jesus and how he chose to love you and me. And we can't earn his love. He just loves us. Our verse of the week is Philippians 1:6. So I want you all to get your Bible out and pause the video and turn to Philippians 1:6 and then press play when you find that verse and we're going to read it together. Okay, let's read our verse, Philippians 1:6. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. We'll be working together all week to learn this verse. This week is encouraging because of what it is promised. He who started a good work in you will carry it on. We will be learning more about this good work all week as we continue. Now, every good construction worker has tools. So we are going to pick tools out of our tool belt. And do you know that God gave us our own tools to get through life? And that is called the Bible. Now I want everyone to get their Bible out. I've got mine right here. So get your Bible out because this is our tool to get through life. Find Matthew 9:9-13. And then when you're ready to hit play, and we're going to read this together. Okay, friends, I have my Bible open to Matthew 9:9-13. Do you? We're going to get started reading our verse. Now, as I read today, I want you to listen to choices that are being made in the Bible during this reading. And also, I'm going to hold this picture up that goes along with our story as I read. Matthew was a tax collector and often sat at a booth where people came to pay their taxes. Many people did not like tax collectors because they often took more money than they were supposed to. They kept the extra for themselves. One day, Jesus was walking by and saw Matthew sitting at the toll booth. Jesus said to Matthew, "Follow me." Matthew got up immediately, leaving everything behind, and followed Jesus. Matthew hosted a grand banquet at his house. Jesus and his disciples came to the banquet. Many tax collectors and other sinners were also at the banquet, eating with Jesus and the disciples. When the Pharisees, teachers of the law, saw this, they began to complain to the disciples. They asked why Jesus would eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners. Jesus overheard the Pharisees talking to his disciples. He said to them, "It is not those who are well who need a doctor, but those who are sick. For I didn't come to call the righteous, but sinners." Jesus was not interested in how good a person was or how bad. Jesus wanted people to listen and follow him. Now, did you hear a lot of choices being made as I read that? I sure did. Tax collectors were choosing to charge more money than they should. Matthew was choosing to follow Jesus when Jesus called him. We should all do that as well. Jesus was choosing to eat with Matthew and the other sinners. And the Pharisees were choosing to ask Jesus about why he would be around tax collectors and sinners. That is a lot of choices. Just like we choose a tool to complete a task, choices must be made all the time. And today's story, Jesus chose to spend time with Matthew and the tax collector. Matthew wasn't well-liked by people, but Jesus still chose to go spend time with Matthew because he loved him. So what did Matthew do that made Jesus want to spend more time with him? Nothing. Matthew didn't do anything special to make Jesus want to spend time with him. Jesus chose to love you and me the same. He already loves us even when we mess up and we sin. Jesus died on the cross for our sin so we can be forgiven. So if you will pause this video and open your Bible to Matthew 15:9 and then press play, we will read this together. Okay, Matthew 15:9. As the Father has loved me, I have also loved you. Remain in my love. Isn't it amazing? Jesus loves us and loves you and chooses to. I needed that reminder today, and I am so excited and thankful for Jesus and this message. This is the gospel message and the good news that Jesus loved us and died on the cross for our sins. Okay, friends, it is game time. Now I'm going to send you on a scavenger hunt around your home to see what you can find. I have been on a scavenger hunt around the church, and I found a cone and a ring to play with. Now you may have these or you may not. Maybe you can find a bucket and a ball, or you can find some sidewalk chalk and a rock, or maybe you can be creative. And I'm going to explain everything to you. I also found on Miss Christina's desk some post-its with the word love. Now, if you're playing as an individual, what we're going to do is take your cone or whatever you may have and see how many times it will take you to toss the ring onto the cone. Now, each time that you get the ring over the cone, you earn the letter to the word love. Now, when you're done, you have earned this whole word. Now, if you're playing with your family or your friends, maybe get the bucket and the ball, and each time that you get the ball into the bucket, you're going to earn the letter to the word love, and whatever team gets the word love spelled out wins. Now that you know that Jesus loves you, how should we treat others? We should love others. That's what Jesus did, and that's what we should do as well. Now each of you should have received an activity book, so I want you to get it out and every day sit down and do your daily devotional. Next up is our craft video, so ask your parents to help you find the crafts for day one. Now, thank you for hanging out with me, and remember, Jesus loves you and so do I.